First, there were helicopters. Then there were drones. And now, there are FPV drones. These little flying cinema cams are now able to pull off shots that could only have been dreamt of decades ago, or even a couple of years ago. But how do these FPV drones work and what makes them so special? Let's find out. This video is sponsored by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform you can use to build a website for your business. One of the main differences between a regular drone built for filmmaking and an FPV drone is in the name. FPV stands for First Person View. This means the drone provides a real-time video feed from its onboard camera to a display, usually in the form of goggles worn by the pilot. This allows the pilot to see a front-on perspective of exactly what the drone sees, as if they were sitting inside the drone and flying it. This immersive experience provides a sense of flight and enables more precise control and navigation of the drone. FPV drones were primarily designed to be used for sport, where they race each other to see which pilot can maneuver the FPV the most nimbly and quickly. Because of this, they are usually way smaller than the big production drones, like the Free Fly Alta 8 or Alta X, which are designed to carry heavy payload cinema cameras on a gimbal like a Movi Pro or DJI Ronin. FPV's smaller frame and lighter weight makes them far more agile and fast, able to fit through small gaps, all with enormous acceleration. Because cinema FPV drones are a bit of a niche product, they are often custom built by their pilots. However, it's also possible to buy some that are assembled straight out of the box. Let's break down what a cinema FPV drone may look like. The frame is what the camera sits on and is made up of a body that supports the camera and battery, and arms that hold the motors that allow it to fly. Usually frames are constructed from carbon fiber, as it's a lightweight material that's also durable. When it comes to building a rig, the name of the game is to keep weight to a minimum. An example of a frame that may be used for a cinema FPV drone setup is the heavy frame from Shen Drones. This is a coaxial octocopter. This means that it has four dual motors that can each turn two rotors. To this frame, a FPV camera will be attached to the front of the drone, along with a transmitter that sends a transmitted video signal using antennas from the FPV camera to a headset that the pilot wears, such as DJI FPV goggles. Inside this headset, the pilot can also set frame lines that mimic what the cinema camera is recording, which are usually cropped in from the wider FPV camera view. This FPV camera is built to be as lightweight as possible and is only used for monitoring and transmission purposes so that the pilot can see where they are flying. It's not used for recording. For the actual video recording, you'll need a cinema grade camera, which is as lightweight as possible. A Red Komodo is currently the most popular. This is due to the trade-off between its light, tiny body and its ability to shoot in a 6K resolution, which gives room for image shake to be stabilized in post, its raw codec with a high dynamic range, and its global shutter, which reduces artifacts and motion blur when filming objects moving at a high speed. When using the Komodo like a crash cam to shoot in dangerous situations where there's a possibility that the camera may get damaged, it's useful that it has no buffering in writing data to the card. In other words, the camera is able to transfer the footage to the CFast card immediately as it shoots it without a delay. So even if the camera crashes and you are able to pull the card out, then all the data should be preserved up to the moment that the camera crashed. The Komodo will usually be paired with a wide angle, compact, lightweight cinema lens, such as a Lauer 0D Cine 9mm T2.9, or a 15mm T2.1. If shooting in bright conditions, an ND filter can be screwed into the thread of the cinema lens. Because no focus motor is used, the focus distance on the lens will be set at a fixed distance, normally at or just off of infinity. A LiPo battery will be strapped to the bottom of the rig. The longer you want to be able to fly the drone for, the bigger the battery has to be. So it comes down to a trade-off between a lighter weight and more maneuverability, or a heavier, less maneuverable, longer flying drone. A 4,500 mAh battery may give the pilot somewhere between 3 to 5 minutes of flight time, depending on how aggressively they fly it. Before we get into how these drones can be used and why they are changing filmmaking, I'd like to thank Squarespace for sponsoring the video. As a filmmaker, you'll need to get jobs as a freelancer, and to do that, you'll need a website where people can contact you and see a portfolio of your work. One of the easiest and best ways to do this is by using Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform that you can use to design a nice-looking website all by yourself by using their templates. Squarespace has lots of useful tools for creators, such as being able to host and showcase your videos. They also have members areas where you can monetize your content by selling access to goods, such as video classes, on your own digital marketplace. So to set up your website, be sure to head to squarespace.com for a free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/indepthcine to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Aerial shots have two noticeable attributes. One, the perspective they provide, and two, the kind of camera movement they achieve. Let's start with perspective. Aerial shots were first done by shooting from helicopters, which provided filmmakers with a bird's eye view perspective that could give context to landscape and provide a sense of scope. For this reason, helicopter shots were often used as a way of establishing a location before cutting into a scene at that location. Because of the safety precautions necessary when flying a large vehicle like a helicopter, this usually limited filmmakers to shooting these establishing shots as wides, far from any building or from the ground. When drones started taking over, they usually adopted the same wide bird's eye view perspective. Even though some stunt helicopter pilots are incredibly skilled and can do amazing maneuvers, their size is still a limiting factor. FPV drones are different. Because of their much smaller size and increased maneuverability, these drones can physically get much closer to objects or to the ground than ever before. Flying closer to objects with a wide-angle lens at a high speed makes aerial establishing shots incredibly dynamic.
You usually have like wide interstitials of the locations as you move from location to location. Anth and I are just bored by that convention, and we wanted to do something more kinetic and more dynamic that would whip you from location to location and just keep the movie moving forward at a breakneck pace.
One of these dynamic establishing shots even involved blending an FPV shot that wove through a hospital entrance with a Steadicam shot that started the scene on the actors, using a quick panning movement to hide an invisible cut. This kept the intensity of the pacing high, while at the same time clearly establishing the space that the scene is unfolding in. This shot also shows off the second noticeable attribute of aerial footage, movement. Although helicopters are able to pick up speed and create dynamic footage, FPV drones are different in that they can make turns and accelerate far quicker, while also using their small size to fit through gaps that wouldn't have been possible before. Shooting with a wide lens close to action has a very different feel to shooting action from far away on a telephoto lens. The physically closer you are to the action, the more visceral, kinetic, and immersive it is.
The drone work is really boring in movies, and I wanted to hip it up. I wanted the energy, because this is a very intense movie. And it just keeps that motion going. And I'm kind of known for how I move my cameras.
So, being able to film aerial footage in both interiors or exteriors, at high speeds, incredibly close to actors and objects, allows filmmakers to get highly dynamic footage without using visual effects. This is all possible thanks to the combination of FPV drones and incredibly compact digital cinema cameras. Although this technology unleashes incredible possibilities, it still has quite a few limitations. They mainly revolve around the weight issue. To be as lightweight as possible, these little drones normally can't use larger cine lenses, a matte box, or use 4x4 or 4x5 6-inch filters to control exposure or create a filter effect. This also means that when shooting day exteriors, much of the exposure control will happen by stopping the lens down to a deep stop. However, this is also necessary as usually these drones can't take the weight, nor afford to power a focus motor. This means that wide lenses with a deep stop need to be used. Therefore, shooting objects close with a shallow depth of field isn't possible. Filmmakers are also limited to very small flight times before they need to change the battery. This makes it impractical to roll for long takes. Also, unlike remote heads on helicopters or larger drones that use a gimbal system, the camera cannot be panned, tilted, or rolled by an operator. Instead, the pilot is the camera operator and needs to position the front of the drone precisely where they want to shoot. Finally, there's also the risk factor. Since a lot of these maneuvers are incredibly fast, it can be dangerous not only for actors, but for the camera. In fact, I remember hearing a story a few years ago about a shoot that was using the first red Komodo in South Africa on an FPV drone for a commercial. The pilot was skimming it over the ocean at a high speed until suddenly, it wasn't just above the water, but under it. And that was the end of the first Komodo in the country. Cinematographers often talk about film equipment like lights, cameras, and grip rigs as tools which they can choose from to chisel each story into the correct shape. An FPV drone is another tool now available to filmmakers, which allows them to get action-packed dynamic aerial movement like never before. Hope you enjoyed this video. As always, thanks to all of you for supporting the channel, especially those that subscribe to Patreon to get these videos early. Otherwise, until next time, thanks for watching and goodbye.